Juventus regard John Charles as their greatest ever import, certainly, probably their greatest ever player. And they've had some wonderful talent down the years. And you only have to go to Italy to understand the esteem in which he's held. He is a god.
Noi siamo stati fortunati, fortunata la Juventus e fortunata la squadra che giocava con un uomo di quel calibro. Sì, è quello, sì, insomma, è stata veramente un compagno in tutto, John. Solo averlo a tavola e guardarlo in faccia, uno era contento.
He used to play for Juventus between Giampiero Boniperti, who was literally the blue-eyed, curly-haired boy of Jean Pommier, of Italian football, captain of Italy, and Omar Enrique Sivori, the Argentinian, who could both, as they say in the vernacular, look after themselves. But one day when he's getting badly kicked, he turned to Boniperti, said, "You do something to them, Boni, I can't."
Per me è stato il giocatore più signore che abbia visto su un campo di calcio. I difensori italiani sono stati fra i migliori del mondo. E quando affrontavano l'avversario lo affrontavano decisamente. Ma John ha sopportato sempre tutto. Per me era un giocatore extraterrestre.
He had the most phenomenal temperament. And as I said, everything was a joke. He was Colossus, Mr. Colossus.
Il gigante è buono, a good giant. That's what it is to call me.
I think you're very proud of that, aren't you?
It's lovely. It was lovely.
John Charles scored 93 goals in 155 appearances for Juventus. He helped them to 3 league titles and thoroughly deserved his nickname, the Gentle Giant.
To say that he never got booked at any time during his career was fantastic. You know? He was big mates with Sivori, and Sivori was one of those niggly little cheeky fellas, you know, who got stuck in, and Sivori went over the top of the ball to somebody and started then proceeding to argue and fight. And I remember it vividly. John walked across to him and just slapped him across the face, and that was his best mate, you know, and as if to say, listen, you just behave yourself. And Sivori might have said something then, and John just shook him, I think. And they got on with the game.
Law going helter-skelter, he nods it with his head, flicks it into the air.
Myself and Joe Baker went over there in 61. We were going to a place that we knew nothing about. But Big John met us when we went over there, and he really was, and although it was the opposition, he looked after Joe and I like a father, really. He told us what to do and where to go and what not to do. And of course, Joe Baker, we were in a crash together, but Joe was seriously, I mean, really seriously injured. And who was the first to turn up was John Charles. We knew then when we went to Turin, there was only one team in that city, and that was Juventus. And the king was John Charles.
I always heard the name and everything, but I think it wasn't until I actually went to Juventus myself to realise how big of a legend John Charles was. You know, I think my dad, when he was alive, you know, always kept mentioning John Charles, you know, how great he was and that, but certainly when you actually look at the videos and everything, when I was over in Juventus, I realised how good of a player he was.
You know, I remember one day, I had to pick him up and take him to Bolton for a dinner. And we left the dinner, it must have been about 10:30, and drove back to Leeds. And on the way back to Leeds, he just came out and said, I was at the old lady last week. Which is Juventus, of course. He said they invited all the foreign players that ever played for Juventus to come to this week of dinners and social events. He said, and I've got this shirt signed by all the players that I'll give you for your son's charity. I just proceeded to thank him, and you know, and that was that. And then the next day I spoke to Peter Lorimer, and Peter Lorimer told me that John had been voted the best foreign player ever to play for Juventus. Now if you think of some of the people that have played for Juventus, foreigners, then it's a fantastic honour. But the point I'm making is that we drove all the way back to Leeds and he didn't tell me. He didn't, you know, have it to say, well, I was voted the best player, foreign player Juventus ever had. He just told me the story about the shirt, and that was it. A humble man, you know, fantastic guy.
The way I look is that you've got Maradona from Argentina, Pelé Brazil, and John Charles Wales. Simple as that.
To judge from the size of the crowd, it looked as if all Welsh Wales had come along to support their national team at Wembley for this 65th tussle with their old-time English rivals. They had their first glimpse of a possible victory when Allchurch passed across the goalmouth and John Charles tapped it in.
The Welsh team was due to be selected, and I said to John, I said, go and get a paper on the station at Newport. I said, because I think the Welsh team would be in there. Well, he got the paper and he come in, and I said, I think you'll be selected. And he was selected. We were both in the team. And it didn't make any difference to him. I always thought he would have got carried away with himself and said, well, he couldn't care less. Because in his own mind, he expected to be in every situation of a football team he would be in.
And in less than a minute, Wales made it 2-2 with a beautiful shot by Charles.
I thought it was lovely to get into the Welsh team, you know. That was a great thing for me at my age, and I thought it was wonderful.
Charles played for Wales in their one and only appearance in the World Cup finals in 1958, but injury ruled him out of their narrow quarter-final defeat by eventual winners Brazil.
I still say that if he hadn't been kicked to pieces by the brutal Hungarians in the previous playoff game, Wales could have won, because all sorts of very tempting centres were coming across the goal, and John wasn't there to head them in.
The only time that I really saw John play when he was at his prime was for Wales. And, you know, like Thursday or Friday, they'd announce that John was definitely playing on the Saturday because he was abroad with Juventus. They'd sell an extra 10,000 tickets on the back of it. People just couldn't get enough of him because they didn't see enough of him.